Hey Indies, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very beginner friendly tutorial for you guys. I am going to show you how to create an off the shoulder ruffle dress for one of my maternity clients. As usual, I will be listing all of the products down below in the description box. Make sure you guys give me a thumbs up if you are feeling the sewing tutorials, and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, honey. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Now, I am using my basic Bodycon pattern to create the pattern for this maternity dress. You guys, it is fairly simple. I do always try to tell you guys, if you don't do nothing else, create you some basic slopers to, you know, help you to be able to get the job done. Now, this particular dress will be in a stretch material. My client is 7 months pregnant. So, you know, make sure that when you are doing maternity dresses, gowns, or whatever, that you try to find a material that's appropriate for the event or the occasion, okay? So it's very important, because with this particular client, it was more important for me to make sure that she was very comfortable and still fashionable, honey. Okay, so what I'm doing right here is I've already divided her measurements into four, and now I'm just creating my markings so that I can, you know, I'll know how far out I need to take this pattern to make it the appropriate size. I'm also gonna take my measuring tape, and I just wanna, you wanna make sure that you measure from the shoulder to floor, whatever the length of the pattern is gonna be. But right now, all I'm doing is taking my see-through ruler and my hip curve ruler, excuse me, and I am just laying the foundation for how I want the silhouette of this pattern to be. And then at the knee, I'm taking my see-through ruler, and that was just a guesstimate, and I just went ahead and extended it out. And you guys, being really honest, it didn't even take me 30 minutes to do this particular pattern. So if I can do it, you guys can do it too, okay? Just trust yourselves, try it out. The beautiful thing about this process is that it's okay to make mistakes. Now, don't make mistakes at the expense of your client's money. However, you do need to practice and, you know, try to perfect your craft. Alright, so what I did right there is I just went ahead and extended it up. It is off the shoulder, but my client is 7 months and she's pregnant with twins. And naturally, when you are doing maternity dresses, the dresses seem to rise because of the client's like stomach. So you have to make sure that you account for that. So even though her shoulder to floor was 57, I did it to, I want to say about 61 inches. And that's just to accommodate for the lift, the lifting in the belly area. Now, you can see that my pattern lost a little bit of its shape. And that is naturally like going to happen. And it's also okay, because you got to remember, when you're doing maternity clothes, you have to account for the size of the woman's belly. And so her belly is going to fill all of this out. So my pattern may appear that it doesn't have much shape, but it fit very well on her. Now I'm just folding back this SS paper. You know, I'm all about getting multi-use out of my garments, like my patterns. So sometimes I'll leave that SS in the front in case I need to alter the pattern to fit something else. All right, so here I am taking my 5 yards of Milliskin, and I am laying it out. Now it is already on the fold, and I'm gonna keep it on the fold because all of the pieces for the pattern will need to be cut on the fold. Now, in most cases, I try to save fabric, but honestly, there wasn't much I was gonna get out of this afterwards, so I just went ahead and cut it as it was once I laid it out. Now, you guys, I have moved into a different sewing area, so I'm still trying to figure out the best angles for this particular room. It is not the same as it was at my suite, which is okay. I just gotta still kind of work it out. So if my angles are a little off, you guys, don't charge it to my heart. I'm going to definitely work on that. All right, so now I'm laying out the second layer, basically, for the back side of the dress. Now, for this particular dress, I use one pattern for the front and the back. So, you guys know I'm not a fan of wasting paper. I don't really have time for that. The reason why I did this is because I knew that it was a stretch garment and it had a lot of stretch. So there was a lot, I guess it was more room for error, if that's the best way to put it. I couldn't go too wrong with it. So I wouldn't advise this for many other garments, but for this particular one, it just worked out perfectly. Alright, so what I'm doing here is just kind of testing out my ruffle pattern. Now, I'd already made my ruffle pattern. I do ruffles a lot, so I actually have so many of them. So this was a 10-inch ruffle, but then I realized that it was too big, and I decided to take it down to 8 inches. So I also took it down to 8 inches because of the fabric. I didn't have enough, and I needed to cut out 8 of these. So yeah, if you are familiar with ruffles and flounces, they use so much fabric, you guys. They really do use a lot of fabric. So you gotta be really smart about how you are cutting out your designs to be able to get the most out of your fabric. So you guys will see how I had to maneuver this process to make it work for me, but it worked out perfectly. So what I'm doing here now is just tracing this particular ruffle onto my alphanumeric paper, and I'm gonna go ahead and take it down 2 inches. So this is a 10-inch ruffle. I'm taking it to 8, and once I sew it at a half an inch, the ruffle will be 7.5. Y'all see Pepper in the background, just being Pepper. She loves to make an entrance. So all I'm doing here is just marking 8 inches from the circle, because the circle with the outline in the center will be cut out. So marking 8 inches from the circle, and you're just marking it all the way around. That way I can have a pretty accurate pattern piece when I decide to cut it. Alright, so now that I've got it to 8 inches, I'm going to go ahead and cut her out. Now, I have a lot of ruffles and they're a lot of different inches, so every time I make a new ruffle at a different inch, I just make sure I mark it on my pattern. And if you guys want to see a video on several different ways to use one ruffle pattern, make sure you guys let me know down below in the comments, because honey, I would love to show you guys how I get down with the flounces. Alright, so now I am just laying out my fabric. Everything is going to be doubled for this particular ruffle. So you're going to see how I kind of maneuver the fabric. You don't want to waste fabric. I already know that I'm going to run out. So you want to make sure that you're cutting on the right end of the fabric. And so for this particular one, you're gonna go ahead and cut out the middle. And then on this ruffle, you are going to cut one side. And the purpose of you cutting one side is so that you can get that expanded flounce. So just make sure you guys pay very close attention to that, because what I've found people to do is to cut both sides, and then they're like, well, my ruffle isn't standing out like yours. It's not a standing out because you cut both of them instead of just cutting one of the folds. So once I cut it on the fold, you'll see again where once I expand it open, it will go all the way across like her bust and her back. And then all of these ruffles, the reason why I needed so many is because I always double my ruffles. I do not do the whole one ruffle with the hem on the bottom. It doesn't matter what I make, I love double ruffles. Now, they do tend to use a lot more fabric, but you know, the quality of the garment will look exactly how you want it to look. Because there's nothing worse than like when you, like if you get like a fast fashion type of garment and they have ruffles, they never line the bottom. So sometimes the inside of the fabric has a different color, all those kind of things, honestly. So it's just always best for me to line my ruffles, and I like lining them with the same fabric. I just think that it, you know, it's a higher quality garment. All right, so now these right here is for the sleeve, and I am not going to cut this. Now, when I cut this last ruffle, it was off a little bit, but I'm going to show you later on in the tutorial how to pretty much work around small problems like that. All right, so what I'm doing here is just putting my side seams together of my expanded ruffles, and I'm going to go ahead and sew down a half an inch. Now, when I was doing this particular part, I ended up getting a call, so I had to cut out a little bit of the video because some of that conversation was into my video and I wasn't aware, so I apologize, you guys. But once I did the side seams for both pieces, because you should have four pieces total, then once you do the side seams at a half inch, it becomes two big pieces. And now I connected the side seam to the side seam, and I am now just sewing around a half an inch. And this is me basically just lining the ruffles with itself, same fabric. So this is a bigger piece, so it took a little bit more time to sew it, which is why I had to just speed the video up. But literally, you're going to go around the whole entire ruffle at a half inch seam allowance. And then once I'm done, you'll see where I flip the ruffle inside out, and you'll just see how good the quality looks with the particular ruffle. All right, so here I am just flipping it out, and then look at how it just lays. Just super, super good quality. I love it. All right, so now I am taking the sleeves, and those ruffles, I did not slit one side, and I'm basically, they're already lined right side to right side, and so you're just gonna go around the whole ruffle at a half an inch seam allowance. All right, so now I am taking the maxi dress, the front and the back, and I'm just gonna go ahead and match the side seams and sew those at a half inch as well. Alright, so what I did here was I completely almost forgot that my client wanted a split, so I had to go back in and add it. Now, I absolutely hate doing my splits this way, but for sake of time, I had to do what I had to do. So I just went ahead and measured out to where she wanted her split to be, and then I went ahead and added it back in. So I just cut it basically. You know, the only thing I hate about doing splits this way is sometimes it comes off more as a U than like a split, but it just still ended up coming out beautifully. So I was like, girl, stop complaining. All right, so what I'm doing here is taking the ruffle that is going into the center, which is the largest one, and I'm just taking that and attaching it to the dress by matching side seams to side seams. Now, I did put 4 pins in this. In most cases, the ruffle is always bigger than the actual around the bust area than the client. So I put 4 pins in it, and you'll see where I'm basically going to pull in the excess fabric from the dress. So all I'm doing here is pulling in that excess. And each time I get to a pin, you'll see with excess fabric, anytime you have to pull in fabric, you want to make sure that you put the fabric that you have to pull in at the bottom and the fabric that is the right size at the top. It just makes it so much easier to gather up all of that excess fabric without leaving like excess puckering and things like that. And that was actually a little tip I learned when I was in school for fashion design. I was like, what? All right, then. So I just need to put this on the bottom and pull it in. So anytime you hear someone say pull in the excess, that is how you do it and, you know, not get so much puckering and pleating or whatever. Now, this particular part was a little tricky for me because my lighting was so bad, and I was trying to show you guys how I attached the elastic in this dress. But basically, it's like a tug and pull method. I don't know how to appropriately explain it. I just think I'm gonna have to do like maybe a swimwear video to show you guys how to do this. But basically, I took a half inch of elastic, and you're basically attaching the elastic with the serger. And the reason why you're doing that is so that you can get a really clean finish. So it's like an extra step to sew the elastic and then serge it, when you can just serge it in and you can both clean off the raw edges of the fabric, but then also insert your elastic to help to make the garment fit the client. And so that was the purpose of the elastic for this particular garment. It was to help kind of add volume to the ruffles, because elastic has a lot of like tension in it or whatever, or elasticity. So yeah, pretty much that's what that was. But my lighting, camera, everything was just so off. So if you guys want to see a video on that, make sure you just leave a comment down below. But I tried to show you guys how I do the tug and pull method to get my elastic into the dress. And you got to make sure you're pulling the elastic, because if you don't pull it, it's not going to give you the, you know, the stretch and tension that you need for the dress to be secure on your client. So once I finished that, I just wanted to show you guys what that looked like. And so what I'm going to do here is now just go ahead and fold the elastic over at a half an inch, and I am switching my my stitch to zigzag, and I'm zigzagging at about three. I want to say it's about three width or something like that. All right, so once I get my camera to start acting right, I went ahead and start stitching the elastic down. But when you stitch the elastic down, the reason why you want to zigzag is so that it can keep the stretch that it needs to keep. But you want to make sure that you are pulling this the same way you inserted it is the same way you need to sew it down when you are on the sewing machine. So far, so good. It's coming out pretty good. I'm liking what I'm seeing right now. And then I wanted to show you guys what the arm ruffles would look like. So I just put them on to myself just to make sure they were comfortable and my elastic wasn't too tight for my client. But now I'm going to do the same exact thing with the arm ruffles. I'm going to fold it over and sew it at a half inch seam allowance. Finish sewing down my ruffles. I am going to go ahead and attach them to the side seams of the dress. So right now the dress looks like a tube top, but once I attach the ruffles, this is for my client to insert her arms into, and this was exactly what I sketched out. But I'm going to go ahead and attach the ruffles at the side seam, and you don't need to do a long seam. It just needs to be maybe about an inch wide, and you want to make sure that you do a back stitch on it, because you don't want to do it too long where it restricts the client's movements, but you don't want to do it too short where if they move the wrong way, your stitch pops. So that's just something to think about, okay? But once I attach these at the side seam, honey, we are good to go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys what this beautiful dress looks like on a mannequin. And then when my client came for her fitting, she also allowed me to get a little footage of her in the dress at her fitting. So you guys, I am so excited with how this came out. I felt like the dress was so beautiful, so sexy, just all around amazing. So this is what it looks like right here on my mannequin. I am so pleased with the outcome of the dress. It looks so beautiful. It's perfect. It matches her theme. You guys, It was such a pleasure to do this tutorial. It was so easy, so beginner friendly. If you have any questions, make sure you drop them down in the comment section below. Make sure you guys hit that notification bell so that you will be notified when we create these videos. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, honey, again. And as always, stay happy, stay humble, and stay blessed. Until next time.